So I'm getting the sense that balance isn't a thing.
Not in the way that we understand it.
Okay,
so when I'm asked the question is always asked this way. How do you balance it all? Balance is a verb. How do you balance it all? And we've got all the analogies, walking a tightrope, spinning plates, juggling balls. Some balls are plastic. Some are glass. Which ones do you let drop? I don't know, John. All that sounds stressful.
you just rattled off like 9 crocheted pillows.
That's so good. Well, that's these cliche answers you get from people that we see as successful. And the truth is, when I look at jugglers, they don't look real happy or balanced or relaxing in their life. I don't want to do that. Yeah. It looks stressful and hard. And it also looks like I could do all that and I've done all that. Walk the tightrope, spin the plates, juggle the balls, and still feel like something's not right in my life. Hmm. And still feel like I'm not balanced, whatever that means. And so I started asking a different question. What if balance isn't something you do, how you balance it all? What if instead it's something you feel? What if it's something you create? What if you could be a balanced person in an out-of-balance world? What if you could create a sense of balance and still be busy? What if balance looks more like peace, being confident in your choices when you say yes to this thing or no to that thing? What if it looks more like, I don't know, just being happy in your life and how you spend your time and shaking the guilt that's been following you around for a long time? I think when we ask about balance, that's what we really want. We just want to be proud of how we spend our time in this one life we've been given. We want to shake this guilt that just haunts us everywhere we go. And so that is the version of balance I define in the book. And you stole my book title with your whole redefining anxiety thing. I wanted to be redefining balance, but we did come up with something else. I don't think balance is about balancing at all as we talk about it. I think we have this pressure to have this 50-50 split between work at home or more common to do everything for an equal amount of time. Hmm. I'm going to work out and spend time with my spouse and spend time at church and spend time with my kids and spend time at work and also personal goals and time with God. And that sounds stressful and it's not realistic. And so the thesis of the whole book is life balance isn't doing everything for an equal amount of time. It's about doing the right things at the right time. And when you do that, you will actually feel that sense of balance you've been looking for. And that's the kind of balance I walk them through in this book.
That's awesome. So I had this thing happen to me the other day. I took my first vacation in forever. And we just went to like a KOA, me and my family. And then we went with another family with little kids. And we had like a pregame meeting where the four of us, like me and my wife and the other couple, we all met and said, "What are you looking to get out of?"
Visualize this? How do you see this vacation playing out?
It was basically I can be weird and awkward, and my wife was trying to predict. I mean, trying to prevent that. So, what do you want to get out of this vacation? What do you want to? And it hit me in a way that I've thought about this before, I've talked about, but it never hit me. And tell me if this circles back here, if you see this. I think at first blush, I wanted to go on vacation so I could do nothing. Mm-hmm. The goal was this illusion of nothing.
Okay.
And I would go, and I didn't have a picture of it. I just wanted to not be doing these other things.
Whatever this is.
Which was food prep and being around people and talking and working. But I didn't have a thing of what we're going to go do. I just wanted to not be doing those things, which meant I just wanted to do nothing.
Yeah.
And then I've looked at the idea, like, I can't wait till I retire. I've had buddies that can't, man, 20 years from retirement. I think I don't want to just do nothing. And I see a trajectory towards getting to like my recliner at the end of every day. Like people just can't, they work all day so I can get here and then they can go to bed and repeat. It feels like this idea of balance, I'm going to run so that I can get to this place where I don't have to do anything.
Yeah.
And I realized that doing nothing, all the research tells me is that your body falls apart, your mind falls apart, your relationships fall apart, and then you just die.
Yeah.
Like if your goal is to do nothing, right?
Yeah.
But I don't know that this idea of balance, this feeling of I'm either getting to a place where I can finally do nothing, mm-hmm. or I can do things that I want to do and there will be no stress or pain or frustration or any. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
What are people looking for when they say, I want balance?
Yeah. Yeah. So that's what's interesting, because when I walk through this whole redefining what this could look like, we talk about what would it look like to have a sense of peace, even in a world that's chaotic, or to be confident in your choices, even when those choices are hard. But you make a good point. I was actually just talking to someone earlier today about this. I think sometimes we jump to these conclusions about certain words and we associate them with something being really negative or wrong. So for example, I'm tired. so that must be something's wrong. Or I'm stressed or I'm overwhelmed or this is a really hard season, so I must be failing. As if we have this unspoken expectation that life is supposed to be easy and effortless. And we know that it's not in our mind. We know intellectually it's not. But then when things get really hard, we think, oh, I'm failing. This is terrible and so on. And the one of the things, I actually talk about this in the book, but I want to differentiate between just because you're tired doesn't mean your whole world is out of balance. Just because you're stressed doesn't mean your whole world is out of balance. Just because you're overwhelmed doesn't mean your whole world is out of balance. Each of those things might be a clue if you felt like that for a decade. Sure, we might need to figure out what's going on with you. But if you just didn't get sleep last night, you might just need a nap.
Or it might mean that you worked really hard that day.
Right.
That's a good thing.
Yes, you might have just had a hard day or you're dealing with a situation you don't know how to deal with. And so when we can separate our conclusions about our whole life from these situations, then I think it gives us a greater sense of power and it reduces all that guilt. So another example I would use is when I talk about seasons, mm-hmm. I've been guilty of this where I look around me and I draw conclusions about myself based on the season I'm in.
Yeah,
so as
dude.
An example, my house is a mess, so I'm a mess mm-hmm. and I'm failing as a mom. I'm like, no, I am not a mess. I have three little kids that make a mess right. every day, multiple times a day. I am not a mess. But if we're not careful, we'll do that. We will draw conclusions about ourselves from our season. And I just want people to know your season is where you are, not who you are.
Right.
Your season is where you are, not who you are. And so this is the season you're in. It's the season of difficulty in your job or difficulty with your health or difficulty with a family member. This isn't who you are.